हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
Chapter 20, I mean, verse 20.
The text 22.
He told you the truth?
That is what he told me, president told me.
Okay. Okay, you can do whatever you like.
No, no, what is today's verse?
We were like on 20.
Oh, really? Okay.
He sang 5, chapter 10.
He sang this verse.
No, no, Maharaj, we finished yesterday.
Finish
that's why I told last night. Chapter 10, text 1 and 2. Okay. Wherever there's a purport. First doesn't have purport, second has purport.
Jai Vishnupad Paramahansa Parivrajakacharya Sri Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada ki Bhuvana Mangal Harinam Sankirtan ki Srimad Bhagavatam ki Gaura Pramanande Hari Hari Bol. ॐ अज्ञानतमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जना शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम्। वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं सग्रजातं सहगना रघुनाथानितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजना सहितं कृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सहगना ललिता श्री विशाखानतांश वंशा कल्पतरुभश्च कृपा सिंधु भैव च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमावं विष्णुपदाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामिने इति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि श्री गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे नारायणं नमस्कृतं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततज मुदरेत मुखं करोति वाचालं पङ्गुलं हयति गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वन्दे परमानन्दमाधवं श्रीगुरुदिनतरिणं श्रीचैतन्यईश्वरं नमः
Pastimes with Lakshmi Devi. It's really, very, very nice. I'm very grateful that Maharaj has come. Along with Maharaj is traveling His Grace Sachikumar Prabhu. Sachikumar Prabhu travels with him in one wonderful person. In fact, his whole family is full of devotees. His two brothers. One of the brothers was Gaura Gopal Prabhu, who used to be a good and now he's living and serving in New Orleans. Prabhu travels with him. Thank you very much. So Maharaj will be here tonight. Tomorrow morning's Bhagavatam class as well, depending on what time his flight is, most likely. But we will call it a matter with a nice fireball.
Om Namah Bhagavate Vasudevaya. ॐ नमः भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमः भगवते वासुदेवाय सो टुडे विल लिसन फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो 5 चैप्टर 10 टेक्स्ट 1 एंड 2 ऑन द सब्जेक्ट मैटर महाराज रहुगण मीट्स जड़ भरत This is prose form. I'll just read the translation. Difficult to read it. Translation. Sukadev Goswami continued, My dear king, after this, King Rahugana, ruler of the states known as Sindhu and Saubira, was going to Kapilasrama. When the king's chief palanquin carriers reached the banks of the river Ikshumati, they needed another carrier. Therefore, they began searching for someone. And by chance they came upon Jada Bharat. They considered the fact that Jada Bharat was very young and strong and firm limbs like cows and asses. He was quite fit to carry loads. Thinking in this way, although the great soul Jada Bharat was unfit for such work, they nonetheless unhesitatingly forced him to carry the palanquin. Verse number 2. The palanquin, however, was very erratically carried by Jada Bharat due to his sense of non-violence. As he stepped forward, he checked before him every 3 feet to see whether he was about to step on ants. Consequently, he could not keep pace with the other carriers. Due to this, the palanquin was shaking, and King Rahugana immediately asked the carriers, "Why are you carrying this palanquin unevenly? Better carry it properly." Purport. Although Jada Bharat was forced to carry the palanquin, he did not give up his sympathetic feelings toward the poor ants passing on the road. A devotee of the Lord does not forget his devotional service and other favorable activities even when he is in the most distressful condition. Jada Bharat was a qualified Brahman, highly elevated in spiritual knowledge. Yet he was forced to carry the palanquin. He did not mind this, but while walking on the road, he could not forget his duty to avoid killing even an ant. A Vaishnava is never envious or unnecessarily violent. There were many ants on the path, but Jada Bharat took care by looking ahead 3 feet. When the ants were no longer in his way, he would place his foot on the ground. A Vaishnava is always very kind at heart to all living entities. In his Sankhya Yoga, Lord Kapiladeva explains, Sruhida Sarvadehinam, living entities assume different bodily forms. Those who are not Vaishnavas consider only human society worthy of their sympathy. But Krishna claims to be the supreme father of all life forms. Consequently, the Vaishnava takes care not to annihilate untimely or unnecessarily any life form. All living entities have to fulfill a certain duration for being encased in a particular type of material body. They have to finish the duration allotted a particular body before being promoted or evolved to another body. Killing an animal or any other living being simply places an impediment in the way of his completing his term of imprisonment in a certain body. One should therefore not kill bodies for one's sense gratification, for this will implicate one in sinful activities. So to kill somebody is sinful activity. That's why in this yuga, yuga dharma is 4 things has been stated. That Krishna sansara kara chadi anachar jibedaya Krishna nama sarva dharma sar. The essence of all dharma, sarva dharma sar. Doesn't matter you're Hindu, Muslim, Christian, the 4 things one should follow. That Krishna sansara kara. You have your family life, have sansar, family life, but keeping Krishna in the center, have your family life. Don't give up your family life. You can continue your family life, but keeping Krishna in the center. And keeping Krishna in the center means keeping Krishna's instructions in the center of your life. So it has not been recommended that you give up family life, but what has been recommended? You give up Krishna Sanchakara Chadi Anachar. You have to give up Anachar, sinful activities. And then specifically has been told, Jibedaya Krishna Nam. Chant holy name of the Lord and Jibbe Daya, be merciful upon other living entities. So that is very important for us to follow. So what does this mean? That Jibbe Daya, we should be merciful upon the living entities. People, they show their mercifulness. But we say Jibbe Daya means you love God. But in India, there's a very famous personality, Ramakrishna Paramahansa. His follower, biggest follower is Vivekananda. You have heard their name? And Vivekananda first came to Chicago. He gave a lecture and became world famous for his lecture. How many of you have been to Vivekananda's place? No? People know Vivekananda in Chicago? Common people, they know. So their philosophy is, Jibbe prem kare jai jan sei jan sebich ishwar. You love living entities. By loving living entities, you serve God in that way. But our philosophy is that you love God. By loving God, then automatically you love everybody. That is our goal. Otherwise, what will happen? You love your family members, then you hate your neighbors. You love your country people, then you hate Iraq, Afghanistan, like that. Now some other were fighting with. You love Hindu people, then you hate Muslim people. Then some people, they say, no, I don't distinguish like this. I don't discriminate like this. I don't see Hindu, Muslim, Christian. I love all the human beings. I love the whole humanity. Then you love whole humanity, then you are killing animals to eat their flesh. That time what happened to Jibbe Daya? How you love the living entities? When are you killing animals? Then how are you loving living entities? But here Prabhupada explaining, but devotees of Krishna, when you love Krishna, then automatically love all his creations. Spontaneously. Loving Krishna means loving his creation. You cannot separate. You can't love Krishna, don't love his creation. Love his creation, don't love Krishna. So this is a very important factor in our spiritual life, especially in devotional life, that Jibbe Daya. So what is the necessity of Jibbe Daya? Why you have to be merciful upon the living entities? Because if you become merciful upon the living entities, our heart will be softened. More violence, more killing, then heart will become like a stone-hearted. But when you plant a seed, you have to plant a seed in soft soil. You put a plant a seed on a marble, never that plant will grow. That's why you have to plant a seed on soil, and after planting on a soil, soft soil, then again you have to do, what is that? Tilling. No, make more soft, then plant grows nicely. But if there's so much killing, so much violence, so much angry, then heart become very hard. Then how can you develop devotion? How bhaktilata kripara will grow? So that's why it has given so much importance out of four things as param dharma, highest dharma, one is jibbe daya, because that is very important factor. How our heart become like very hard, stone hearted. Now Jadabharat, he has a feeling. He's not just doing some drama. He's feeling from the heart, oh, one aunt will be killed. One aunt will be killed. But for us, what does it matter? Your aunt will be killed. Some insect will be killed. We are walking. We have to look like this. Oh, where is aunt? We don't feel. Aunt will be killed, okay, no problem. But that is where it starts from. That is where it starts from. Today, aunt will be killed. Oh, no feeling. Oh, small aunt killed. Then tomorrow people, they kill a fish. When they kill a fish and they throw on the ground, I have experienced in my karma life, I go to the pond to catch the fish. And when they kill the fish, you feel very enjoy. But how fish is feeling? He's jumping in ecstasy. He's feeling torture, he's pain. But when fish is feeling pain, we are enjoying. That is how it starts. Heart becomes hard, hard. Then today you kill insect, no feeling. Tomorrow kill a fish, fish is suffering and you don't feel. Because heart has become more hard. Then tomorrow you kill a chicken, and chicken doing so much suffering and you are enjoying. Tomorrow you kill a goat, you are enjoying. Then tomorrow you kill a human being, you don't feel. It's a gradual process. How our heart become hard. Not only that, you kill a human being, you don't feel. That is why so many people are killing human beings. They have no feeling for that. So these terrorists, how cruel mind, they spill thousands of people, they kill. And sometimes you cannot believe. Just kill somebody, but it's so bad way they kill also. Very horrifying way. Their heart becomes so hard, they just don't feel satisfied just chopping up somebody's head. Very horrifying way they will kill somebody. You can't believe how they kill. I don't know, describe to pollute your mind. No. The way I have heard the terrorist people, how they kill the people. One terrorist, sometimes terrorist people also become very close to us. So he was telling, he was a terrorist. We were discussing with him how people, they want to live, they don't want to die. He was telling one horrifying story, I'll tell you. Then they have to kill somebody, and they called him and they told him, you bow down. When he bowed down, then he was telling, he stood up and he's walking after, got a head chopped off. So it's like this. There's no feeling. No feeling, only not for killing. Very torturing you have to feel. Then they feel, so nice. That becomes enjoyment of the life. Just like Mrigari, isn't it? Mrigari would kill all the birds and animals and leave them half dead. And when Narada Muni came, asked, why are you killing? They are my livelihood, I have to kill. Then Narada Muni said, if you have to kill, then kill them. Why are you living half dead? No, I enjoy that. No. Somebody's sufferings become enjoyment. Then what that society will lead to? What that society will lead to? From insect to fish to goat to kill other human being. And that killing attitude will not be limited to killing others. That killing attitude also will be extended to kill your brothers, to your sister, to your father. In America, people, they kill each other. It happens in America. They kill their parents, their brother, their mother. This has become a common news now. You will not see in one day there is a newspaper. At least in India, I have seen. There is not a one day the newspaper will have no news of as such. At least half dozen news. Half dozen news, and many are not noticed. Half dozen news.
brother killing brother, son killing father, all killing and killing. Why? Where this mood comes from? Because we don't have feeling. Starts from killing an ant. It starts from there and goes all the way up to what is the most horrible killing going on the earthly planet now? Can you tell? More horrible than that. Aversion. Aversion. Shastra says there is no sin. The greatest sin. Yesterday somebody was asking why Kali Yuga is so bad, right? In that program. And Satya Yuga, Tritya Yuga, big, big demons where they are. So that Yuga also very bad. As if nowadays no demons are there. There are one Hiranyakasipu Kansa. Now everybody Hiranyakasipu. I think we are worse than Hiranyakasipu. We never read in Purana they're killing baby in the womb. And Indra captured Kayadu, and Indra knows there is a demon inside her womb. He did not know Prahlad Maharaj, great Mahabhagavata, but he thought he's a demon. He's his enemy, he wanted to kill. But he did not kill even if Kayadu, because she's a lady. She said, I'll take you and wait until the baby takes birth, then I'll kill. Nowadays, just see what degraded we are. And we are thinking we are a very civilized society. Tritya Yuga, Dwapar Yuga, demons were there. Now there is no demon. Why Kali Yuga is so much badly described? Bhagavata says, Pasyati cha pasyati. We don't see even if we see. So that is how it goes up to that level. And with that kind of mentality, mood, then how can we develop bhakti? So it is very, very important. Jibbe Daya Krishna Naam. We have to develop mercy upon the living entity. That Chaitanya Bhagavata describes. Even if what to speak of physically torturing to somebody, mentally should not torture also. Mentally also should not torture. And usually we become very careful for Vaishnava Parad. But Chaitanya Bhagavat limits us or advises us not to limit our behavior to Vaishnavas, to every living entity, to all living entities. What to speak of human beings, to animals, to birds. What to speak of human animals, but to trees also. Shastra says, sometimes people they say, ask us question. You are teaching vegetarian, you are saying you don't kill, but you are killing. You are killing trees. Tree has a life, That is not sin. Killing trees sin or not? That is also sin. Prabhupada is saying, unnecessarily you cut trees, that is sin. Even if for eating we are killing trees, that is also sin. That's just to eat a vegetarian food, it does not mean that you are free from sin. Just to eat vegetarian food is not sufficient. That food will become free from sin when you offer to Krishna. A killing tree, plants, that is also sin. And what to speak of killing human beings, killing animals, birds, killing tree, even non-living things, if you misuse, that is also sin. Non-living things, the devotees, they are so much careful. Non-living thing like water. If you open a tap, water is running like this, devotees cannot tolerate. That's what happened. Prabhupada was in Mayapur. He was doing morning walk. Then one tap was little open, dripping water, one small. Then he became very angry. Why Krishna's energy is misused here? So that far goes the compassion of the devotees, to the trees, to the plants, the animals, to everybody. So by that what happens? That softens our heart. And the soft field, when we plant this bhakti creeper, then bhakti creeper grows. That's why the heart is compared to field. Brahmanda Brahmite Kono Bhagyavanajib Guru Krishna Prasadapaya Bhakti Lata Bij. After hovering around in this material world, in this Brahmanda, from time immemorial, from body to body, from species to species, from planet to planet, then Guru Krishna Prasadapaya Bhakti Lata Bij. By mercy of Guru and Krishna, we get the seed of Bhakti Lata, the creeper, Bhakti creeper seed we get. And where we plant this seed? Which field we plant this seed? On the backyard? The courtyard? The belly? No, in the head. No, with the heart. With Hridaya. Hridaya Kshetra. Hridaya is the Kshetra. That's why we say, I love you. How I love you? Through my belly, through my hand. I love you by my heart, right? Through heart we love each other, no? We don't love each other through belly, or through leg. That is the place, the heart. And that's why it has been stated. That is the main place, that is the field that we plant this Bhakti Lata. Then we prepare this field. This is the preparation of the field. That the field become very soft. Very soft. How? By being compassion upon others. By being compassion upon others means, you know what? By being compassion upon others means, when others feel suffering, you feel suffering also. Others enjoy, you enjoy. It's like that. The compassion is like that. You feel non-different from other entities. That is compassion. But the material world is designed in such a way, you cannot enjoy by seeing others are enjoying. You suffer by seeing others are enjoying. Actually, our enjoyment in this material world, if you analyze nicely, my enjoyment is not how much I am enjoying. My enjoyment is not how much I am getting. My enjoyment is to see how much you are suffering. Yes. If I am getting $1 million, I am not happy. Because you have $2 million. But doesn't matter, I have $1,000, I am happy. Because you have $500. You understand? Yes, this is the basic principles of material enjoyment. You can't avoid this. We can't avoid this. That's why material enjoyment is not how much I get. How more I get, that is not the cause of my enjoyments, happiness. How much less you get, that is the source of my enjoyment. To see how less you get. I'll tell you a brief story in this regard. In Orissa, there are many tantrics are there. The tantrics, they do sadhana, betal. Some ghost entity they control. So one tantric went to forest to do betal sadhana. Then the betal was very pleased. Then betal appeared in front of him. Said, I'm very happy with you. Tell me what boon you want. Then this tantric from a village, small village, he said, you bless me. Whatever I think and meditate upon, immediately I will get that. Immediately I will get that. So Betal was very happy. Betal said, let it be so. And whatever desire you will get it. And this man was very happy to hear that. But Betal said, the second line was, whatever you will get, your neighborhood will get double than you. But this man was so happy by hearing the first line. The second line he did not hear properly. So he's very happy that whatever he'll think, he'll get it. Then he went to village. Village people, then he's thinking, let me see the boon I got. So he went inside his house. He's meditating to get something. You know, in India, for village people, what is the greatest achievement in their life? For any villagers, the greatest achievement in their life, if they can build a big house, that is the greatest achievement. A straw house, they can make a building, oh, my life is my human life is successful. They think like that. So this villager, he went inside, all villagers have a straw house. He went inside his room, house, meditating, oh, Betal, if you are pleased with me, please let him have a two-story building. Then when he opened his eyes, he was supposed to he has a two-story building. So he was happy. But actually, to some extent he was happy, not fully. You know, when real happiness comes not when you get things. Real happiness comes when others see that you have got things. A lady will buy nice sari, nice ornaments, decorate, sit inside the house. She'll feel happy. As soon as she'll decorate, go outside, see how nice I am. Then real happiness comes. You show others. Not only you show others, others will be jealous of you, then you become happy. Yes. When you're showing others, what are you showing for? To make him happy? No, just see. You burn, he burning. I have, you don't have this. That is the mood, inside that is the mood. Yes, you don't have, I have this. So that gives pleasure. No. That gives, you have a nice car, nice something, you want to show to your friends. No. Your nice house, you bring your friends. No, just see, I have, you don't have that. That is the basic principles of happiness. Just imagine this villager. Another source of happiness is comparing. As I said, comparing, just like this villager. This village man, everybody straw house. The whole village they have straw house. And he is thinking to have a two-story building is biggest achievement. With everybody straw house. So to have a two-story building in a village like that, big achievement, very happy, great happiness. Just imagine. Somebody has a two-story building in New York, Manhattan. What happiness will derive out of that? A 20-story, 30-story, 40-story building. But how, this is a relative subject matter also. The two-story building, in one place will give you greatest achievement, happiness. In other place, will give you distress. Somebody in Manhattan has a two-story building, it's a distress for him. No? All big, big buildings are there. So this man, he is now thinking that everybody has straw house, then so from inside house, he wanted to come out and show. The whole village will see. Everybody have two-story building. So he came out of the house to get the real enjoyment. Then when he came outside the house, he did not get enjoyment. What he saw? Neighbor had a four-story building. And by seeing that, what to become failure, what is become happiness? He was tortured. Wow, yes, four-story building. Then he went inside, then meditating, let me have one four-story building also. So immediately got a four-story building, then he went out, has eight-story building. Can you understand how torturing is this? And he's improving, he's going inside, improving opulence more and more to be happy. More and more he's trying to be happy by improving his opulence. More and more he's suffering. But neighbor getting double. Doesn't matter how much things he gets. He simply suffers and suffers and suffers. You understand? That by getting we don't enjoy. By getting we don't enjoy. No? He's suffering more. More he gets, more he suffers. But neighbor getting double. What a stupid thing is this? No? He's trying how to, day will come, he'll have less than me. So more things are accumulating, more suffering. After a long time, he got some good idea. He got some intelligence. Then he's thinking, okay, whatever I am getting, this man getting double than me. So what he did, he went inside his house and he's meditating upon Betal. Oh Betal, if you are really happy with me, please you bless me, one of my eye will become blind. So one of his eye become blind. Then when he went outside, his neighborhood got double than that. Two eyes blind. When two eyes blind, he was very happy now. Wow, now I achieved something. You understand the source of happiness? This source of happiness. So much has accumulated, not happy. His one eye got blind, no problem. My neighborhood, two eyes blind. No. So that is what happens. Now people, they don't feel happy. We don't feel happy with others' happiness. And why we don't feel happy with others' happiness? Why are we so much envious? Why are we burning? Why are we feeling tortured? If others are enjoying, happy, why? You know why? What could be? Speculate. Can you speculate something? Any speculation? Anything else? Yes, the root cause is your envious of Krishna. That is the origin of this mood, the mentality. The origin of this mentality. Once His Holiness Bhakti, that Africa Maharaj. No. Bhakti Chaitanya Maharaj from Durban. Bhakti Chaitanya Maharaj was explaining. Just imagine, to go back to Godhead, how much free we have to be from this enviousness. Up to what degree free we have to be. He was telling, in this material world, if somebody's little opulence, little beautiful wife, we are feeling tortured, envious, wow, why he has so much good? Why he has so much nice things? And if you can tolerate this much, when you go back to Godhead, to Krishna, and there you see Krishna, Maharaja is telling, the one boy, and millions of most beautiful gopis looking at him unblinking eyes. When you see that, how much tortured you will feel. Wow! No? Very nice point he made. That makes our path very difficult. No question we can go there. So one boy, all these beautiful girls, you will be really suffering there to see that. How can we reach that point? We can't reach that point. And that is the reason we came here. We are envious of Krishna. We don't want to surrender Krishna. We don't feel happy that Krishna is enjoying. And my Krishna's enjoyment is my enjoyment. Guru's enjoyment is my enjoyment. Living entity's enjoyment is my enjoyment. Three things Kapila Dev explaining. And opposite to these three, called Bhirna Bhav, Bhirna Drik. That is separatist mentality. Separatist mentality means we have separate interest than the interest of Krishna. Separate interest than the interest of the Guru. Separate interest than the interest of the people in general for their happiness. These three separatist mentality. And to go back to Godhead, it is that difficult it is. And we are ourselves, we can examine where we are now. Little bit somebody doing, what to speak of ordinary karmic people living a devotional life. Some devotee does good, we feel, he's doing so good. No, we don't feel sometimes happy. No. If that is there within our heart, what is our chance to go back to Godhead? So surrender is very important. So that's why it is very much important to soften our heart. Otherwise we cannot surrender. Whether to surrender? Surrender means, spiritual world surrender is not like material surrendering. Now you surrender to me, I defeated you, you are forced to surrender, accept me as my God, Lord, my Lord. Spiritual is not like that. You surrender with love and affection. For that, what we have to do? That become big sannyasi, big GBC, big temple president, something very big, isn't it? Do you think you will go back to Godhead? In your life you can't become GBC of ISKCON, a temple president of ISKCON? Is it possible? Somebody can be a sweeper and go back to Godhead, and President or GB should be sitting here. That doesn't matter. Now, what we have to do? Also, maybe Sam Maharaj or Bhaktisar Maharaj, maybe I was telling a nice pastime in Vrindavan. And once, this Kansa, every day sending demon to kill Krishna. He used to send one demon in morning, one in noon, one in afternoon. Yes. Maharaj was telling Krishna would go for grazing cows, but he doesn't need to take care of cows. Cows do not go away. He will always stay. He will leave the cows and calves. He just have fun. They play. Just play and play and play. And they play so much, they forget when it's time to eat. And that time they had no citizen watch or sikho watch, nothing there. So how they will understand? And one demon will come, Krishna will kill. Then the boys will recognize, oh, now it's time for eating. Every day it is regularly happening. Every day. That is like a regular life. Some demon killed him, it's time for lunch. Then they will eat. Then again start playing. Then they forget when to go back to house, their home. Then again another demon will come, Krishna kill, oh, now time to go back. The daily routine was like that. And Kansa is thinking, what is going on? I'm sending all these big, big demons and nobody coming back. What is happening in Vrindavan? So Kansa said, let me go and see what is happening there. So once Kansa tried to come in to Vrindavan from Mathura himself, then when he reached at the border of Vrindavan, then immediately Kansa found one old lady standing there. And she has a stick in her hand. And Kansa going, he's the king of the Mathura, with your royal dress and everything, trying to go. The old lady saying, hey, don't come inside. Don't enter this area. Kansa, who are you? I am king of Mathura. Then Kansa, the lady, that old lady, swing a stick. Be careful, don't come inside. Then Kansa, he does not care. Who cares? It's the old lady. He's trying to push himself. Then this lady, she knows some magic. She transformed Kansa to a small girl. That lady is Purnamasi. She's Purnamasi. She cares, take care of Vrindavan. Then Kansa became a small girl. His mood is like Kansa, but body is a small girl. What can he do? He's not so much powerful now. The whole lady chastising and getting heavy on him. You can't come. If you want to come inside Vrindavan, then you have to take some special training. Then Kansa said, what training I have to take? Then this lady said, old lady, Purnamasi said, the training you have to take, that all these cows are grazing here, you have to go and collect all the cow dungs from there. Then for Kansa to collect cow dungs, it's big embarrassment. No, I will not do this. No? Then this old lady swing the stick. You will not do this? You have to do this. This is very heavy. You have to go collect all these cow dungs. This is a small girl, very scared. Okay, I'll go collect. Then Kansa, the small girl from, he running around and calling to all the cow dungs. So after some time, Kansa saying, okay, so can I go now? Inside, I'm qualified now. Then the old lady said, what qualified? You just passed the grade 1, now you have to go to grade 2. You have to take admission in grade 2. Then Kansa said, what? Grade 2? What is that again? Then this lady said, grade 1, you just collected the cow dung falling on the ground. Grade 2 is when the cows will pass stool, before that stool fall on the ground, you have to show your hand and collect that. And that is too much for Kansa. I cannot do this. No? You can't do this. You have to do this. No? He's showing the stick. No? Kansa got so scared. Okay, I'll do it. No? The cows are standing here and there. Some cow passed a stool. Then this lady says, hey, run there, get the stool. Kansa would go and collect that stool and bring that cow down. Hey, run there. So there's one cow standing at a far distance. When he was passing stool, the lady says, hey, go run there. Then Kansa ran to collect the cow dung. And he went a little far distance. And from there, he ran away from there. He ran away. Then Purnamasi said, yes, Kansa, be very careful. Next time you come, I'll put you into grade 3 then.
never come here. So the lesson from this is, the conscience was very ego. Now, I'm so big, now, so ego, I'll do this cow dung collection. But what was the business of Brajavasis? What they're doing? What greatness they had? They're investing money in share market. Big businessman, what are they doing? All the ladies whole day, they're doing this cow dung business. They collect cow dung, make cow dung, that is whole day, that is the business. So that much humble, soft one has to be Krishna's devotee. Not like also a big man. The gobar gote, somebody collects gobar cow dung. That is regarded in India, the low class service. But third class, fourth class people. In India, cow herd people have somebody who has no brain, they're cow herd boys. Somebody for no use. Okay, you go graze cows on the field. Just see, Krishna is so expert, he's supreme personality of Godhead. He could not take any other service. So who is Bhagavan? Now my Bhagavan is Krishna. Now what your Bhagavan is doing? Now whole day he's grazing cows on the field. Sometimes I see, Krishna could not take any other better service. Something regarded as brainless service. Someone has no brain. Krishna took up that service. Because he's very expert. He knows how to enjoy the life. He gives Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva. You take all the headache. Creation, maintenance. I go graze the cows, no headache. Play with cowherd boys. And I go to forest. And all the gopis will come, I'll have fun with them. The God is full of fun. He's expert. He's intelligent. And his devotees are intelligent also. In outside world, how big you are, right? Raise your head. Raise your chest. Oh, yeah, he's real human being. But spiritual world is opposite. The Bhagavan and Bhakta, both are in different group. Bhagavan takes a very important service, grazing cow. And devotee takes an important service, making cow dung. Cow dung cake. In a civilized human society, who will appreciate the service? Right? Nobody will appreciate the service. But this is the topmost. So one has to find the sweetness. One has to be that much sharp, intelligent, to find the sweetness, the greatness of becoming so small. That's why I say, everybody try to become big. Why everybody try to become big? Do you know? Why everybody wants to become big? Speculate. Any speculation? Any other speculation? Yeah, everybody wants to become God. Everybody wants to become God, that's why everybody wants to become big and to become equal with God. Materialistic transcendentalists, jnanis also think the same way. And to become God. Because God is very intelligent. You know how he's intelligent? We cannot become God. No, why we cannot become God? God is saying, I am very big. You try to become big, you will become God. But God, he has another trick. You know why God is God? General concept is God is God because he's greater than the greatest. Yes or no? Yes or no? But that is wrong concept. God is God, not he's greater than the greatest. He's greater than the greatest and smaller than the smallest. Anur anyan mahato mahyan. He's greater than the greatest, smaller than the smallest. So that's why, but due to ignorance, you are thinking God is greater than the greatest. You are trying to become greater than the greatest. But nobody is trying to become smaller than the smallest. So Bhagavan is saying, yes, yes, you try. Go on becoming greater than the greatest. But never you can become like me because you never tried to become smaller than the smallest. But I can become smaller than the smallest. That's why jnani, yogi, karmi, they all fail to compete with God. But devotee, they can compete with God. They can defeat God. That's why they say,
যে কৃষ্ণ ভাজা সে বড় চতুর, ডিভোটিজ অফ কৃষ্ণ দে আর ভেরি ক্লেভার, যে মায়া ভাজা সে হ্যা ফতুর, ওয়ার্শিপিং মায়া দ্য ব্রেনলেস দ্য ট্রাইং টু বিকাম বিগ, দে ক্যান ডিফিট কৃষ্ণ, হু ক্যান ডিফিট কৃষ্ণ, ওনলি ডিভোটি ক্যান ডিফিট কৃষ্ণ, বিকজ দে নো দি ট্রিক, দে নো দি ট্রিক, হাই কৃষ্ণ হাজ বিকম সো গ্রেট বিকজ এ স্মলার দেন দি স্মলেস্ট, সো দ্যাট ইস ডিভোটি ট্রাই টু বিকম স্মলার দেন দি স্মলেস্ট, ইজ নট ইট, দ্যাট ইজ মহাপুরুষ ফিলোসফি, হ্যাঁ তৃণাদপি শুনিচেন তরডিপি সহিষ্ণু আমানি নাং মানে দেনা কীর্তনীয় সদাহরি, দেন মহাপুরুষ সিং অলসো নহং গৃহস্থ নহং বিপ্র নরপতি ন দিস নট দ্যাট, গোপী ভর্তুর পদকমল দাস দাসানু দাসহম, উই আর নট সর্ভেন্ট অফ গড, সর্ভেন্ট অফ সর্ভেন্ট অফ সর্ভেন্ট অফ গড, সো দিস ট্রিক ডিভোট ইজ দে ন, দ্যাট ইজ দ রিজন হোয়াই দে হ্যাভ ডিফিটেড গড, দ্যাট ইজ দ রিজন হোয়াই দি সুপ্রিম কন্ট্রোলর ইজ কন্ট্রোলড বাই ডিভোটি, দি ট্রিক ইজ নট ইন ইয়র লাইফ টু বিকম ট্রাই টু বিকম গ্রেট, ট্রাই টু বিকম স্মল, দি গড হ্যাজ দিস প্রিন্সিপল অ্যান্ড ডিভোটি দে হ্যাভ দিস প্রিন্সিপল, অ্যান্ড মেটেরিয়াল ওয়ার্ল্ড বিগ কম্পিটিশন, হাউ বিগ আই ক্যান বিকম, হাউ গ্রেটার আই ক্যান বিকম দেন ইউ, অ্যান্ড স্পিরিচুয়াল ওয়ার্ল্ড বিগ কম্পিটিশন ফর হোয়াট, বিগ কম্পিটিশন ফর হোয়াট, হাউ স্মল আই ক্যান বি বিটুইন হুম, বিটুইন গড অ্যান্ড ভক্ত, বিটুইন ভক্ত অ্যান্ড ভগবান, ভক্ত সেজ আই এম ইউর সার্ভেন্ট, ভগবান সেজ আই এম ইউর সার্ভেন্ট, হিয়ার এভরিবডি কম্পিটিং হাউ আই বিকম মাস্টার, দেয়ার এভরিবডি কম্পিটিং হাউ আই বিকম সার্ভেন্ট, ইয়েস, সো দ্যাট ফার দ্যাট অল ডিপেন্ডস, দ্যাট স্টার্টস ফ্রম কিলিং এ অ্যান্ট and goes all the up to this, how our heart has to reach that point, that we, this is the tricks, the spiritual scriptures, they have revealed to us to make our life successful and go up to that level. And Rahugan, King Dajaran, no, not Jada Bharat teaching, now he'll continue more and more things, who is great, who is smaller, who is king, who is carrier, the greatness is not the goal of life. To become small is the goal of life. Any question you have? If you just tell. That's why it doesn't matter whether others they are know or not. Your consciousness will purify yourself. You don't need it to make others know, oh, I am doing so much for you. It's not necessary. To make your heart simple, humble, soft, you have to raise your consciousness within yourself, whether they recognize or not. No, we do it for ourselves. And one day ultimately people will recognize. But that is not their goal of life. That I am so humble, I am doing service to you. You please feel very much, some gratitude towards me. Not necessary. For that don't, better, rather we don't do that for purpose. If I do service, people will recognize. They will understand how humble I am doing, I have service. Not necessarily. That is not our goal. Our goal is we develop this mood to serve others. Irrespective of what they're thinking towards me or not, whether they recognize, they don't recognize, doesn't matter. Yes, no, some, yes, some others raised hand. Okay, President Prabhu. Okay, okay. You see the different degree of offenses. That you beat some devotee, or you kill some devotee, very gross offense. Or you rebuke some devotee, shout, scold, hurt him, weaker offense, Or you are doing a general service, sometimes it happens, because sometimes some offense committed. That is different category of offense. You know, the different categories of offense. So when you are doing a daily service, see, overnight you can become free from offense mentality. But the gross offense, that will really hamper, you know, progressing our spiritual life. And some subtle offense or mental you thinking, that has some effect, but that is not so gross like others. Then you are saying how to overcome even if this small offensive mentality. My understanding is, more we progress in spiritual life, we become more sensitive for even small offense. So initial stage, what will happen? Due to our previous sanskar, we commit offense. But after committing offense, because we have progressed in our devotion life, we'll feel, oh, why I spoke to Prabhu like this? I should not have spoken. He must have felt hurt. If your heart is hard, I rebuke, shout, scream, oh, I have done correct. No, why did he got a good lesson from this? You understand? One devotee can do Vaishnava aparad and very badly, say, I have done correct. He should get a lesson from this. But sometimes after hurting somebody, I hurt because I have nature, previous sanskar. Then I feel, oh, I should not have spoken like this. No, he felt hurt. You understand both mood? So that repenting, that will rectify us. No, at least recognizing one step ahead. The point is, more we improve in devotion, not spiritual life. Spiritual life, devotional life are two different. More you progress in devotion life, your heart feeling will become more sensitive. For small things you feel, oh, this is Vaishnava Parad, like that. That will arise from within. And of course externally, by hearing, by discussions, time to time will progress in that direction. Will cultivate. It's a cultivation, we have to cultivate. How to refrain from Vaishnava Parad, all the way from gross mood to subtle mood. It's a cultivation, exercise, one kind of exercise. We have to do that. We can take a tablet and tomorrow, I'll have no Vaishnava Parat. That system is not there. You want to become a bodybuilder, muscular body, then you have to do lift weight. Now you have to go through the problems. So you have to go through the problem of a Vaishnava Parat. You have to do Vaishnava Parat. Then gradually, you will overcome it. If you think, oh, I'm doing Vaishnava Parad, so I just abide, stay somewhere, solitary place. That way you will not become free from Vaishnava Parad mentality. Your mentality will be Vaishnava Parad. That's why you have to engage in devotional service. You have to mix with Vaishnavas. Sometimes you will commit Vaishnava Parad. That is a part of devotional life. We want for Shuddha Nam. But part of our chanting is to commit offense and chant rounds. That is part of our chanting. By committing offense and chanting rounds, one day you will reach Shuddha Nam, Shastra says. See, committing Vaishnava Aparad, don't be worried for that. But how to become devotional service, improve and feel more sensitive, gradually look into this, sincerely cultivate, that is important for us. Okay? Thank you so much. Hare Krishna, Hare Bol. Jai Shri Prabhupada ki, Srimad Bhagavatam ki, Gaura Pramanande. Hare.